Do you want to make animations like this? Step one, upscale. Use this program, which takes any image, is able to upscale it to like a way higher quality. It's gonna help give your images a clean look when animating. Step two, create your project. Choose 4K or 1080p. I typically use 29fps, but it's open to whatever you like. 24fps is actually the animation standard. So why aren't you using the standard?
I'm better! I am better!
Nah, I'm just kidding, but I do like the slightly smoother look of 29fps. Step 3, cutting out assets and cleaning. Now you're going to want to cut up your assets into separate parts depending on what you want to animate. This includes hands, arms, legs, etc, etc. When you cut out certain parts, other stuff might be overlapping with it. This is when you're going to need the clone stamp tool. Now this tool is almost like magic. It helps you recreate textures to clean up your assets like this. Step 4, animate.
That's what I've been waiting for. That's what it's all about. Woo!
Preparing the
manga animation.
Are you ready? Okay, the secret formula is...
Okay, no, but seriously, the four tools you're gonna need for a basic animation are keyframes, the puppet tool, liquify, and CC bend it. Keyframes are used for basic positioning movement. You have a position, scale, and rotation tool. The puppet tool allows you to add pins onto an image and distort it however you want. This allows you to get smoother looking movements that don't feel super static. You can do animation things like squash and stretch, etc. Liquify is another tool that's similar, but it gives you a brush that can morph things. This helps with giving you a 3D perspective. You can enlarge parts of the frame such as the mouth, or you can make it look as if a head's looking down. CC bend it, very similar to the first two. You can put a start and end position and literally bend it. This is a great tool for doing hair animation, but you can use it in many different ways. Step 5, coloring. If you choose to color your animations like a psychopath, what you do is pre-comp the layer you did the animation on, but select leave all attributes in the original comp. This will keep your animation stuff separate. Now you can use adjustment layers, mask, and tint to color in the images. Always look at references to help out if you're new to it. Step 6, compositing. This is a super important step to make your animations pop. You want something more like, rather than. During this scene, there's a building on fire. So we're taking a night background and overlaying different fire elements to blend it all together. There's also layer styles, which you could add highlights and glows. The two I use are inner shadow and inner glow. In this animation, I used an inner glow to highlight edges around his body to match up with the fire. After I combine this, I pre-comp it all into one final layer. I add a position wiggle effect for intensity when he screams. After that, I added a lumetri color for color correction and a glow effect to make the fire pop out around him. Step 7, rendering. After everything is finished, add your project to the render queue. You'll want to export it as a PNG sequence, which is standard for animations. Sometimes when you render as a QuickTime file or something, you might run into... Step 8, importing to editing software. Click import and click on the first image of the render. It will give you an option saying something like insert as PNG sequence. After it's imported, you can click interpret frame rate and you choose the one you had on After Effects. Then a little bit of this. And boom! You got yourself a finished product. If you want to see the project file, it'll be linked down below with a bunch of random resources I mentioned. I hope you guys enjoyed. Check out the Twitch streams if you want to see me working on stuff live, and support me on Patreon where project files will be posted for certain videos.